I'm showing a live audience the journey of a cow from paddock to plate. Now, Grant the Butcher is going to show how our favourite cuts are only a tiny portion of these huge beasts.
So we're basically going to start at the top and work our way down, right down the body, finish at the tail and with the offal as well.
I've also asked along Melbourne chef Shane D'Elia to demonstrate how a nose-to-tail approach makes use of the whole animal and celebrates the so-called secondary cuts.
I hate the whole term secondary cuts. My grandparents never called it secondary cuts. For me, it's about what tastes the best.
That's the same animal that we saw in the paddock.
We're starting with the forequarter, which, along with the brisket and the chuck, contains the popular ribeye.
I know what a ribeye is, but I have no idea which part of the body the ribeye came from.
The ribeye becomes the Scotch fillet once removed from the bone. The Scotch fillet runs along the back of the cow, above the rib cage. From a 500 kilogram animal, there'll only be 3 to 5 kilos of this classic steak.
It's not much though, is it? Off that whole side of the body.
Like only, 3 kilos or something is a Scotch fillet. It's like the only cut I know and it's this big. So I thought that was crazy.
Can I get you to put your hand up if you go to a butcher's shop where you would see chunks of animal like this hanging and they will cut it off for you?
A lot of the less popular cuts have become more difficult to buy, as butchers often only source the primary cuts they know they can sell.
Consumers drive this. Absolutely, you are stitched in to the production cycle. When you request a certain cut, it prompts the production of it. So if you're constantly requesting T-bones and fillets, the market is going to supply that to you.
If we can learn to eat more of the so-called secondary cuts, we could potentially farm fewer cattle, thus reducing the environmental impact of eating beef.